And to reach this kind of decision, it's a very personal decision, it's a very difficult decision, and I thought Admiral Fallon said it best. Is he has to recognize the effect it's having on his mission, his ability to command, and he came to a point that he couldn't do that to support those objectives and other objectives in what is clearly the most important command we have in the world right now, and therefore reach this decision to step aside. Again, I respect that and respect him. I haven't seen anything that of substantial difference, and he said more than once that from the policy perspective, that's not his lane. We in the military are required to carry out our orders when we're given them, and the orders are essentially set by policy. So I haven't seen any significant difference there. And the other challenge we've got is are the JAM special groups in Baghdad and in southern Iraq. And so the challenge is,
what is the JAM special group?
Those are the groups that are tied to Muqtada al-Sadr, and Sadr's got a freeze on.
And he has continued it.
He's made that
the
decision.
Surprise of some.
And that's true, and in some cases even to the surprise of his own people. And by and large, that's been a significantly positive part of where we are.
And why is he doing that?
I think that question is still out there. I honestly don't know that. I mean, he's clearly, he has said publicly that he's studying religiously, and he comes from a very famous father, and that he kind of wants to, we think he wants to follow in those shoes.
To be the religious or the political leader, leader?
Well, I think right now to be a religious leader, I think he clearly has a very strong following politically and his militia. So I don't think it's exactly clear where he's headed.
Okay, but do I hear you saying we may have a different attitude about where, we may at least raise questions about where, what his intentions are, and whether he can play a productive role, because there was a time earlier in which
right.
he was viewed as a principal
right.
enemy, and the idea was we wanted to go after him,
right.
the United States did,
right.
but Ayatollah Sistani
right.
said no.
Right, and he is, right now, I mean, he is playing a more productive role than he had in the past. In that regard, and how that plays out in the future with respect to him and the people that he influences, I think is still a question.
If we had credible evidence and intelligence that said where Osama bin Laden was, what would the Pakistani government do and allow us to do?
I honestly don't know right now, and I think that's open to negotiations, and I'm not negotiating, but it's certainly open to discussions with this new government.
For the better or for the worse? For
the
better
or the worse? Clearly the leadership in Pakistan is aware that this is a huge concern of ours, has supported that. I mean, certainly President Musharraf has supported that. But with new leadership coming, I think that's a question that's out there and that we're going to need to engage them to make sure they understand the depth of our concern, and then how do we work with them in their in their country, within their borders, to address this threat.
Join us online at charlierose.com.